This is Captain Philip with Airworthy Tours, your guy in the sky. And today we're taking a tour of the beautiful city of Rio de Janeiro. Now we have a lot of topics and points of interest to cover, as well as some great music to listen to. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the tour.
Rio de Janeiro translates to January River. However, there is no river in Rio. It got its name from Portuguese explorer Gaspar de Lemos, who in 1501 led an expedition and arrived at a huge bay in Brazil, known today as Guanabara Bay, in January of 1502. Mistakenly thinking the bay was the mouth of a river, he decided to call the area Rio de Janeiro after the month he arrived there. The city of Rio de Janeiro was founded in 1565 by the Portuguese, where it would become a major hub for sugar production and thus the slave trade. Between the 16th to 19th centuries, an estimated 2 million enslaved Africans were imported into Rio. After the Portuguese king was kicked out of Portugal by Napoleonic France, Rio served as the capital of the entire Portuguese Empire from 1808 to 1821. Brazil would declare its independence on September 7, 1822. And slavery would be abolished in Brazil on May 13, 1888, with the signing of Lei Áurea, the Golden Law, signed by Dona Isabel, the Princess of Imperial Brazil. Rio would serve as the capital of Brazil from 1763 until 1960, when the capital was moved to Brasilia. However, Rio still remains Brazil's cultural capital. Perched on many of Rio's hills, you will see favelas. A favela is a slum or shanty town that sits within or on the outskirts of Brazil's largest cities. Favelas typically come into being when squatters occupy vacant land at the edge of a city and construct shanties of salvaged or stolen materials. Most modern favelas appeared between the 1950s to 1970s, when millions of people left rural areas of Brazil and moved to the cities. Unable to find places to live, many people found themselves in favelas. In total, some 12 million Brazilians live in favelas, which is about 6% of Brazil's population. In Rio alone, close to 1.5 million people, around 24% of the population, lives in favelas. Rio has a large population of 6.7 million, making it the second most populous city in Brazil after Sao Paulo. And people from Rio de Janeiro refer to themselves as cariocas. Now let's talk about Rio's world-renowned beaches. Our first stop is my favorite beach in Rio, Ipanema, made famous by the iconic bossa nova song, The Girl from Ipanema. The song became an international hit in the 1960s and won a Grammy for Record of the Year in 1965. Bossa nova is a musical style of samba mixed with jazz that originated in Rio de Janeiro in the 1950s and early 1960s. It is a very influential musical genre and has been played in major movies to elevators and high-rise buildings.
We have a playlist of some of my favorite bossa nova songs. The link will be in the description box below.
The large mountain range in the background is known as Dois Irmãos, or the Two Brothers Peak. And Ipanema offers some of the best surf swells in all of Rio. Our next stop is Copacabana Beach, which is one of the most famous and popular beaches in the world. The beach runs for 2.2 miles and has dozens of beachside restaurants and vendors. Many vendors will try to sell you my favorite Brazilian drink, the caipirinha, which is Brazil's national cocktail. During the 2016 Summer Olympics, Copacabana served as the venue for beach volleyball, triathlon, and open water marathon swimming competitions. Like Ipanema, Copacabana also has a famous song named after it by Barry Manilow. However, while the song's concept was conceived right here on Copacabana Beach, the song's about the now defunct Copacabana nightclub in New York City. If you know anything about Brazilians, it's that they love their football. This is most demonstrated by the giant Maracana Stadium, opened in 1950 for Brazil's first World Cup host. The stadium has a capacity of 79,000, making it the largest stadium in Brazil. However, its record hold is 173,850 for the 1950 World Cup final between Brazil and Uruguay, which is the Guinness World Record for the largest official attendance at a soccer match. Unfortunately, Brazil lost the match in a 2-1 upset. The Brazilian national team has won a total of 5 World Cups and 1 gold medal, which was won right here in Maracana Stadium in the 2016 Olympics. In addition to hosting the 1950 and 2014 World Cup finals, the Maracana Stadium was also the site for the opening and closing ceremonies of the 2016 Summer Olympics. Ahead is Sugarloaf Mountain, which sits at the entrance of Guanabara Bay, Brazil's second largest bay at 159 square miles. Sugarloaf Mountain stands at 1,299 feet and is one of Brazil's most iconic natural landmarks. Its peak can be accessed by taking a cable car. From there, you will find beautiful 360-degree views of Rio. The first cable car line opened back in 1912. Since its opening, an estimated 35 million people have ridden the cable cars to the top of the mountain. But another way to get to the top is by rock climbing. Sugarloaf Mountain is one of the largest and most popular urban rock climbing destinations in the world, boasting 270 different routes. No trip to Rio is complete without a visit to the Christ the Redeemer statue, Brazil's most iconic landmark. This colossal statue of Jesus Christ sits at the summit of Mount Corcovado. Created by French sculptor Paul Landowski and then constructed by Brazilian engineer Heitor da Silva Costa and French engineer Albert Caquat, construction of the statue took 9 years, beginning in 1922 and finally finished up in 1931 at a cost of $250,000. Its funding came directly from the Catholic Church of Brazil. The statue stands at 98 feet tall. Its wingspan stretches out to 92 feet wide. It is made up of soapstone and reinforced concrete, and it weighs 655 tons. It is the third largest statue of Jesus Christ in the world. Each year, Christ the Redeemer is visited by nearly 2 million people. In July of 2007, the Christ the Redeemer statue was declared as one of the new 7 wonders of the world. Make sure to stop at our gift shop at www.airworthyprints.com for beautiful travel posters of Brazil for your home, office, or home office, free shipping on all purchases, and for staying for the full length of the video, make sure to use the coupon of AirworthyRio for 10% off on your purchase.
If you enjoyed today's tour, you can tip your tour guide by hitting the like button. Also, make sure you subscribe to the channel to be a part of future aerial tours. You can also check out some of our tours of Brazil and Latin America right here. Thank you for flying with Airworthy Tours, and we look forward to seeing you on our next flight.